Hello and welcome back to Tesla News. My name is Marian and I'm your host today covering a lot of numbers for Tesla, proving that Tesla is a big growth story, despite some news talking the opposite. And we have the big luck to use analytics and numbers from James Stephenson. And thank you so much for him. He's doing some really, really great work, and we will just start and dive in. So for the quarterly revenue, we do see that the first quarter in 2021 with $10 billion is so much higher. It is almost twice the size as in 2019. So we do see there is massive growth happening here. It is not stopping, guys, not like everyone is saying out there. And furthermore, this growth is also being seen when it comes to the cars and the models. And the Model S will come out now in the next few weeks. They will deliver them. So we do see his estimates here. And of course, they are estimates, guys. So be careful. They are not, he has no proof that it will happen that way. So we do see that the Q2 is around 218,000 cars, like I predicted as well, around about. And then further growth in Q3 and Q4. Especially because we might expect some Model Ys in Q4 from Austin or maybe as well Giga Berlin. And then we do see the production and deliveries, and the difference is always try to be really close because Tesla is trying to push everything out after each quarter to really have an inventory very low and bring all the cars out to the customers as soon as possible. The growth that we see here will also be seen in the next chart in a second, and it is because Austin and Giga Berlin in the next 2 years will play a major factor. Looking into the gray section of numbers on the right side, he is expecting Q2 to be around 13 billion, 15 billion in Q3, and then Q4 $17.5 billion. Again, guys, these are estimates, but what I find really interesting are the auto gross margin, and they are excluded with no credits inside. So around 30 to 32%, and it makes actually a lot of sense because we do know that the LFP batteries are in China making a major part because they are really good but as well cheaper. And the big question is when it comes to the supply chain issues that we all know about, Tesla has increased the prices. So the margins should be very good in the coming months. And I do expect when the Model S and the Model X is getting out there right now, as they do it, that the margins will get even better because we know the 22% in Q1 was without any Model S and Model X, just a few 2,000 that were from last quarter. So saying that and summarizing these numbers, it really shows that Tesla is just really close in hitting a really hard growth in the next quarters. And this is also because Tesla is working on Giga Austin and Giga Berlin to finalize those production areas. And once they are ramping up, guys, there is no stopping anymore. We had a lot of quiet time right now, but now we are close to get crazy here. For the quarter regulatory credits revenue, he is expecting that they will decrease, which makes a lot of sense because more and more automakers are going into EVs. And yes, I do expect that this one issue that people are always saying Tesla is only profitable because of these credits. We will look into some numbers that show that these credits are just a really small part of the revenue. Furthermore, we do see that in Q3, he is expecting Giga Berlin. I don't think that this will happen. And this is also fine. It might be in Q4 if we are lucky, or Q1 next year. And then for the little gray part on top of the blue one, this is for Austin. Really hard to say how much impact those two factors will have in this year. And then we do have the Shanghai factory with the Model 3 and the Model Y. looking into what average $1 or where the $1 of revenue when you slice it up is coming from. We do see it's clearly the automaker, the cars that Tesla is making money with. Regularity credits are just 2 cents of a dollar, then leasing 3, and energy part is 6, and then service and other is 7. So we do see that the credits are really not paying a lot of, make not a lot up when it comes to that statistic. Looking at what cars other car companies have, how many they have, and how much sales they do with them, we do see the Model 3, Model Y, and we do see as well Model S and Model X for 2020. He's taking that here into consideration. So I must say it is really, really exciting to see that Tesla is managing to do so many sales with so less cars. Going into the premium vehicle sold in the US by 2017 to 2020, we do see that Mercedes, BMW, Lexus, Audi, Buick, Acura, Cadillac, and Infiniti, they are all losing sales, guys, and the only one that is increasing is, yes, you heard it right, Tesla. So we do see how much impact Tesla has on the premium market here, and we have to see how the performance, for example, of the ID4 in the United States is. They just released that one, but Tesla has such a big brand awareness, and considering all the gas scandals, diesel scandals that we had for VW in the United States, we have to see how good the brand awareness is when it comes to VW. So I'm summarizing what we just saw based on the statistics here and numbers. And thanks again to James Stephenson. It's really, really kind of him that I can use that. I do think that we are close to a major step where we will see another major milestone coming when it comes to growth. This quarter, around 218,000 cars, and then moving upwards. And I think by next year, we will talk about an average of 250,000 to 300,000 cars easily when those two factories are going as hell. So as we are looking at Austin here, we do see they make really good progress. And I'm really looking forward to see when we will have Cybertruck, Semi, Model Y going out at this place, guys. So if you did enjoy my channel, it is free. So if you like it, do consider subscribing. It would really help me out. And I wish you all a wonderful day. And I hope to see you all back very soon at my channel. And thank you very much for your support.